Within the Ethernet standard, we have a useful flow control feature called the pause frame. Sometimes one device will send so much traffic that the other parts of the network can become overwhelmed, causing congestion. If nothing's done about this, some traffic will eventually be dropped. An overwhelmed device can send a pause frame to the original sender. This asks it to take a break from sending, which allows other devices to catch up. The goal of this is to prevent frames from being lost. This might happen if there are devices of different speeds on the network. A high-speed device can easily overwhelm a low-speed device. Practically though, this is common in switches themselves, where they might have many devices sending traffic and can't forward it out fast enough. Pause frames use a special type of Ethernet frame called the MAC control frame. In this case, MAC means media access control. It's not the same thing as a MAC address. Anyway, this frame is used to send network information rather than regular data. In this case, an opcode of 1, which means it's a pause frame. These can be sent to a specific destination address or to a multicast address. If it's multicasted, all senders who receive it will pause sending data. Inside the frame is the pause duration, but this isn't measured in seconds or milliseconds. Instead, it's measured in a unit called a quanta. A quanta is equal to 512 bit times. So what's a bit time? A bit time is the time it takes to put one bit on the network medium. So a bit time will vary for different interface speeds. Now for the practical question. Do I need to enable pause frames or does it just work in the background? This is a feature that you can enable and disable. Whether it's on or off by default will depend on each vendor and device. You might have seen settings for flow control on your network interfaces. This is how you control pause frames. We can set RX, which enables receiving pause frames, TX, which enables sending pause frames, or both. This is usually set per interface and only on full duplex interfaces. Keep in mind that some devices may not support sending pause frames. This comes down to each vendor and device. There is a problem with standard pause frames. When a sender is asked to pause, they will pause all flows. This is absolutely not ideal, as it may result in interruption of real-time traffic like voice and video. So, to address this, pause frames were upgraded in the 802.1QBB standard to priority-based flow control. This enables pause frames to be sent on a per class of service queue. This means that lower priority traffic can be paused while leaving high priority flows alone. We could even have a different pause time per queue. And that's how pause frames work. I hope that helps you to manage your networks better. Take a look at the rest of the videos on this channel, as I'm sure there is something that will interest you.